And he answered, laughing, between two smoke rings, "Were there not the fat dogs?" End of A Hyperborean Brew, Section 2 of The Faith of Men by Jack London.
Section 3 of The Faith of Men by Jack London. Tell you what we'll do. We'll shake for it. That suits me, said the second man, turning as he spoke to the Indian that was mending shoes in a corner of the cabin. Here you, Billy Bedham, take a run down to Olson's cabin like a good fellow, and tell him we want to borrow his dice box. This sudden request, in the midst of a council on wages of men, wood, and grub, surprised Billy Bedham. Besides, it was early in the day, and he had never known white men of the caliber of Pentfield and Hutchinson to dice and play till the day's work was done. But his face was impassive, as a Yukon Indian should be, as he pulled on his mittens and went out the door. Though 8 o'clock, it was still dark outside, and the cabin was lighted by a tallow candle thrust into an empty whiskey bottle. It stood on the pine-board table in the middle of a disarray of dirty tin dishes. Tallow from innumerable candles had dripped on the long neck of the bottle and hardened into a miniature glacier. The small room, which composed the entire cabin, was as badly littered as the table, while at one end, against the wall, were two bunks, one above the other, with the blankets turned down, just as the two men had crawled out in the morning. Lawrence Pentfield and Corey Hutchinson were millionaires, though they did not look it,